HER2-positive breast cancer represents about 15 to 20% of all new cases of breast cancer. And in women who have HER2-positive breast cancer, and the occasional man, of course, who may have this, there are too many copies of the HER2 gene in the nucleus of the cancer cell, and that gives rise to too much HER2 protein on the surface of the cancer cell. As a result of HER2, the cancer cell is able to grow and spread and invade more readily. HER2 is something that is very important for the cancer because it helps it survive and flourish, which is, of course, good for the cancer and bad for the patient. This used to be one of the worst subtypes of breast cancer, and it probably does tend to affect younger women a little bit more than older women, although we see it across all ages. But what has changed is that over the past 15 years, we have developed so-called targeted treatments for HER2-positive breast cancer. The first of those treatments is the drug Trastuzumab, which a lot of people call Herceptin. But there are three additional targeted treatments that are now approved for HER2-positive breast cancer, which include the drug Pertuzumab, and a drug called T-DM1, and a drug called Lapatinib. All of these are very important drugs for HER2-positive breast cancer. Sometimes they're used alone. Most of the time, they're used in combination with other treatments, specifically chemotherapy or other forms of anti-HER2 treatment. And they can be very, very effective. And what has changed is that as a result of these treatments, there are more women with early stage HER2-positive breast cancer who are cured of their cancer, and even in women who have more advanced forms of cancer, who have stage 4 or metastatic HER2-positive breast cancer, these drugs have prolonged life and, as importantly, have dramatically affected quality of life.